The annual report gives us a great opportunity to give feedback to our tenants and other stakeholders about how we've performed over the course of the last year. There is a housing crisis up and down the country. In places like Liverpool, there's still major problems around affordability, around having the right homes in the right places, about enabling people to not be impacted by the bedroom tax in the way they have been, and giving smaller properties to meet smaller families, and in some cases, different forms of tenure. The Brexit vote and the decision to come out of the EU will have major impacts upon the country and on our sector particularly. Fortunately, LMH is financially very strong and well positioned to respond to those challenges going forward. The summer budget was a major element and a major impact upon social housing organisations. In that budget, the government put forward its strategy of cutting social rents by 1% over the next 4 years. And that's got an impact of actually reducing LMH rents over that 4 years by 16%. That meant a £30 million loss of income from our business plan in those 4 years, and a £300 million loss of income over the full length of the 30-year business plan. LMH took an immediate response to how we need to change to respond to that agenda. And part of that was to realign our services in a way that made LMH an even fitter and leaner, pure landlord, focusing on its key objectives of providing quality housing and associated services to our customers and our tenants. The lifeblood of LMH is rent, and we need to get our rent in efficiently, and we need to let properties efficiently so we're not making rent loss. So rent first is a way of placing rent and rent collection at the heart of everything we do. We've made in the region of £1 million worth of core overhead savings, and we've reduced our staff numbers, which we've had to do to respond to the agenda. But we've done that in a way that's made us fit going forward, but also respects our employees. Our strategic housing partnership with Liverpool City Council and Redrow has really took on pace this year. We're looking to deliver new homes towards our target through that partnership of 1,500 new homes and 1,000 empty homes back into circulation. The year saw us move into shared ownership and other products, so we have a wide range of products that we can offer our communities to provide their housing. We've completed our programme of investing in 17 schemes that provide housing for over 55s, and that's been a major investment for LMH, but has also transformed the product in those areas, the type of housing, and has been really well received by our tenants living in those homes. We need to give people the ability to improve their lives once they're living in one of our high quality homes. So key to that is getting people into employment first and foremost, and providing services which get them digitally included so they can access benefits where that's appropriate, or access the job market. So key elements of our strategy are not only giving people a home, but giving people the wherewithal in their broader life to actually take advantage of that new home. In the new year, we'll formally launch Commutual, which is the new charitable organisation, which will provide all those community regen services and everything else. I will also incorporate the Toxteth Firefit Hub that provides great services for young people in the Toxteth area of the city. But we'll have outreach from there, which will provide services right across the city. Looking forward, it's going to be a very challenging time for our sector. Quality organisations providing great services and being efficient and providing excellent value for money will thrive and prosper even in that difficult environment. And LMH is very much one of those organisations.